Hey guys, hope all of you are doing well. Okay, so today we'll be doing illustration 27, which is on page number 1.39. Well, it says, from the following receipts and payment account of Accountants Club, prepare income and expenditure account for the year ended 31st March 2020. So they have given us the receipts and payment account for the year ended 31st March 2020. So on the debit side, you will find all the kinds of receipts, both capital and revenue nature, and on the credit side you'll find all the kinds of payment which are both revenue or capital nature. Okay, the question for this is, subscription in arrears for the year ended 31st March 2020 is 1,35,000 rupees, and subscriptions received in advance during the year ended 31st March 2020 is 39,000 rupees. Okay, further it says insurance premium prepaid is 3,000 rupees. Okay, the details of the details with respect to stationery of Accountants Club is as follows. So they've given the opening and closing balance of the stock, they've given the opening and closing balance of the creditors, and they've given the information with regard to advance payment for the stationery made so far. Done. So let's begin. So illustration 27, heading is Accountants Club. So this has to be ACCOUNTANTS, Accountants Club, income and expenditure account for the year ended 31st March 2020. So let's begin with the income. So first income is subscription. So this is my debit side and this is my credit side. Okay. By subscription received, guys, if there were no adjustment mentioned in this question, I would have straight away taken this amount as my income in the outer column, but unfortunately we have certain adjustments, so I cannot take this amount into outer column. I have to take it into inner column and do certain adjustments. 1,24,000 rupees. Okay. So it says subscription in arrears for the year ended 31st March 2020 is 1,35,000 rupees, which means during the financial year 1920. So let's say, what is my current year? So my current year is 1920, previous year is 1819, and subsequent year is 2021. Okay, so during the current year, 1,35,000 rupees worth income has been earned, but we have not received it because they say subscription are in arrears, so we are yet to receive it. So since it is yet to be received, definitely this 1,35,000 will not be included in 1,524,000. So we have to add outstanding subscription at the end of financial year. Yes. 1,35,000 rupees, right? Okay, so it further says subscription received in advance during the year ended 31st March 2020 is 39,000 rupees, which means during this year we have received 39,000 rupees, but technically this 39,000 rupees worth service I would be giving in the financial year 2021, that is next year. So I will be rendering the service in the year 2021, but I have received the money in 1920. If I have received the money in 1920, definitely this amount of 39,000 should be included in 1,524,000 rupees. But since I'll be rendering service in the next year 2021, so income will be earned in the financial year 2021. So I have to reduce this minus amount from 1,524,000 rupees. So less subscription received in advance at the end of financial year, which is 39,000 rupees. So my total would be 1,524,000 plus 1,35,000 minus 39,000. So 1,620,000 is my income. 16,20,000 is my income. Okay. In case you want to know how this would look in my ledger format. So let's say we draw a ledger of outstanding subscription. Question has no information with regard to opening balance. Opening balance will be zero. So opening balance is zero. So this is my debit side. This is my credit side. Since this is asset account, opening balance will be on the debit side. But since we don't have any information with regard to opening balance, we assume it to be zero. So we have closing balance. Closing balance, it says subscription outstanding is 1,35,000 rupees. So this means income earned and not received is 1,35,000 rupees. This is to subscription income. So outstanding subscription to subscription income. We have earned 1,35,000 rupees. So this is income earned but not received. This amount of 135 only has been added to the subscription amount. Right? Okay. Let's say subscription received advance ledger. Since this is a liability account, opening should be on the credit side. Since we have no information with regard to opening balance, so this will also become zero. But they say that by the year end, we had closing balance of 39,000 rupees. So how did this 39,000 closing balance come? This closing balance has come because this 39,000 was received in cash or bank. So entry would have been cash and bank to subscription received in advance. So this 39,000 was received. It has gone to liability account because this is the amount received for the financial year 2021. So technically 39,000 is the income earned for the financial year 2021. So this 39,000 has been minus from 15,24,000 rupees, because this 15,24,000 rupees include 39,000 rupees because we have received this in cash or bank. Right? I hope this concept is clear. So let's go for further. It says donation 7,20,000 rupees. As I mentioned in the previous illustration, it's given as plain donation. So I would consider it as general donation. So general donation means it has to come to my income and expenditure account. So by general donation, 7,20,000 rupees. Had they given specific donation or special donation, this would have gone to my balance sheet under liability side. Okay. Then I have interest on investment. I don't have any adjustments with regard to this. So straight away in my outer column, interest on investment. How much it is? 18,000 rupees. Then we have entrance fee. So by entrance fee, 1,80,000 rupees. All these items are revenue in nature, hence I am recording in my income and expenditure account. Then interest received from bank. By interest from bank, 63,000 rupees. Sale of old newspaper. Again, it's an income. So by sale of old newspaper, which is 9,000 rupees. Right? Okay, done. So with this, we have done with the income side of income and expenditure account. So let's proceed with the expenditure column. So first item of expenditure is salaries. So to salary, have no adjustment with regard to salary, so straight away this will go to my outer column. So 4,95,000 rupees. Okay, done. Now, next item is stationery. So total payment made for stationery is 89,700. So to stationery 89,700. I have put this in another column because I have certain adjustments to be done with regard to stationery. Right? So I'll be solving this in two method, guys. I'll teach you two types of different methods on how to calculate the stationery value. You can choose whichever is convenient for you. Okay. Now, guys, if you come to adjustment, they say the details of with respect to stationery of accountants club is as follows. So they're given opening balance of stock and closing balance of stock. Further, they are given the opening balance of the creditors and closing balance of the creditors. So opening creditor is 26,000 rupees. So what does this mean? What does this 26,000 means? This 26,000 means goods or stationery has been received in the financial year 1819, that is previous year, and amount was not paid in the financial year 1819 so far. So this 26,000 implies these stationery were purchased in the financial 1819, but till 1819 this payment were not made. So since nothing else is given in the question, we would always assume that this 26,000 rupees payment would have been made in the current year. If this 26,000 rupees payment is made in the current year, obviously this 26,000 should be included in 89,700. I think this was a similar point which I mentioned in subscription also. If there is any opening outstanding subscription, if nothing is mentioned in the question, we always assume that that amount is received in the current year. Similarly, since this creditor is a payment related item, this 26,000 indicates the purchase happening in financial year 1819, that is previous year. So payment is made in the current year 1920. If the payment is made in the current year 1920, this 26,000 should be included in 89,700. This 26,000 is already charged to expenditure in the previous year 1819. So if I do not eliminate 26,000 from 89,700 rupees, this will again be charged as expenditure in the current year also. So I should reduce 26,000 rupees less opening creditor. 26,000 rupees has to be subtracted. Right? So let me give you a bigger picture. In financial 1819, guys, I am talking about previous year. What entry had I passed? Stationery expense account debit to creditor. 26,000 rupees and 26,000 rupees. So this 26,000 rupees has been charged to my expenditure, income and expenditure account in the previous year itself. Because when I prepare income and expenditure of 1819, under the expense side, I would have recorded stationery expense as 26,000 rupees. So in 1920, what is happening? 1920, payment is happening to the creditor. So creditor is getting closed. So creditor account debit to cash or bank. To cash or bank, this 26,000 is getting paid. If this 26,000 is paid, definitely this 26,000 should be included in the 89,700, because this 89,700 indicates total payment made towards stationery. So since this 26,000 is already charged to expense in the previous year 1819, current year, if I do not minus this 26,000 rupees from 89,700, this 26,000 will be again booked as my expenditure, which would be wrong. Right? Further, it says that during the current year 1920, outstanding creditor is 40,000 rupees. So this means in 1920, I have bought certain stationery items. So stationery expense account debit to creditor. How much? 40,000. 40,000. So that is how this 40,000 has come as closing balance in the current year. So since this is expenditure incurred but not paid, so obviously this 40,000 rupees would not be included in 89,700 because 40,000 is not paid. But I have to record as expenditure because I have incurred the expenditure. It's only that the amount is not paid. So I need to book this as my expenditure. So add closing creditors, or you can write creditors at the end of the financial year, whichever is convenient. So this will be plus 40,000 rupees. Right? Okay. I hope this is making sense. Now, the question further says, advance paid for stationery. So advance for stationery paid in 1920, which means obviously this payment is again pertaining to creditors. The only difference is in 1920, we had paid 7,000 in advance, which means in 1920, I would have paid the money, but stationery is not received. Since stationery is not received, the expenditure is not incurred. So in 1920, what is my third entry? Third entry is creditor to cash, which is 7,000 rupees. So creditor is now on the debit side, having a debit balance. So the creditor has received the payment from me, but this guy has not given me the stationery yet. Because the wording used in the question is advance for the stationery paid. So till the financial year in 1920, I made the payment to him, but this guy has not given me the stationery item till the financial year ended 31st March 2020. So unless and until I receive the goods, it is not my expenditure. Just suppose if this guy is not delivering the goods, this guy will give me the payment back. So my technically expenditure incurred would be only when the stationery item is received. So, since the 7,000 rupees is paid, obviously the 7,000 will be in part of 89,700. I cannot record the 7,000 rupees as expenditure because goods have not been received. Since goods are not received, I cannot claim my expenditure. So, let's advance to creditor in the end of financial year. So advance paid to creditor at the end of financial year, so minus 7,000 rupees. Guys, I hope the logic is sounding clear. The creditor, which is there in the first entry, to whom 26,000 is being paid, this person and this person, which is in the third entry, could be different persons. Sometimes in business, it so happens that from one person, we get the goods and then we make the payment. In certain cases, what happens is the creditor would ask the payment upfront, first advance payment. After the advance payment is released, only then he will give goods. So both the kinds of scenarios will come across in a business. So the next point what they are trying to say is advance paid for stationery carried in 1819, which means in 1819, apart from this entry of 26,000 rupees, another entry was passed for advance payment. So in 1819, there was another creditor to whom I made the payment, but this guy did not deliver me the goods. So to cash, 5,000, 5,000. So 1819, I paid him the money. So if 1819, I paid him the money, I would assume that 1920, I would have received the goods because in nowhere in question, they mentioned that we have not received the goods. So definitely this 5,000 worth goods would have been received in 1920. Then what would be the entry here? Fourth entry should be expense. So stationery expense to creditor. So I'll be closing my creditor. 5,000 rupees. So creditor is getting closed. But I need to book the expenditure. But if you see, this 89,700 rupees will not include my 5,000 rupees because this 89,700 talks about only money received and paid. Technically money paid. So this amount of 5000 rupees, the money is paid in the financial year 18-19. So definitely this 5000 will not be included in 89700. So I need to add this as advance to creditor the beginning of financial year. So plus 5000 rupees. Because this, the moment the goods are received, I have the right to book as expenditure. So I have received the goods in 1920. So technically the right to claim expenditure arises in the financial year 1920. So I have to add 5000 to 89700 rupees. So 89700 minus 26000 plus 40000 minus 7000 plus 5000. So my total expenditure that I would record in my income and expenditure account should be 1,01,700. Okay, now, so this 1,01,700, guys, let me tell you, this is not my stationery, but this is my total purchase. This is my total credit purchase. So, 89,700 minus 26,000 plus 40,000 minus 7,000 plus 5,000 indicates total purchase made for the financial 1920, which is 1,01,000 rupees. This is the current year's total purchase. This is my total purchase. Question has further given my opening and closing stock. So my opening stock is worth 30,000 rupees. With this, I add my current year's purchase, which is 1,01,000 rupees. So my total expenditure or total purchase, both opening stock and current year's purchase put together, would amount to 1,31,000 rupees. I cannot record this entire 1,31,000 rupees as expenditure because of this 1,31,000 rupees, stock worth 5,000 rupees has still not been consumed. Sorry, the opening balance is 30,000 rupees. Sorry, opening is 5,000 rupees. This is not 30,000, guys. My mistake, I'm sorry. The opening stock is 5,000 rupees. So this should be 1,06,000 rupees. The opening stock is 5,000 rupees. Total purchase made in the current year is 1,01,000 rupees. So total amounts to 1,06,000 rupees. So this 1,06,000 rupees I cannot record as my expenditure for the simple reason being I have 30,000 worth stock which I have not consumed. So less closing stock worth 30,000 rupees. So 1,06,000 minus 30,000, which is 76,000 rupees. I think we made a totaling mistake here. So 89,700 minus 26,000 plus 40,000 minus 7,000 plus 5,000 amounts to 1,01,700. 1,01,700. is 101,700. So this will become 106,700. So 106,700 minus 30,000 is 76,700. 76,700. So I have, during the current year 1920, we have consumed stationery worth 76,700. So this is the amount that will go to my expenditure account. So with this, add opening stock of 5,000 less closing stock 30,000. So 89,700 minus 26,000 plus 40,000 minus 7,000 plus 5,000 plus 5,000 minus 30,000. So amounts to 76,700. 76,700. So this is minus, this is plus. 76,700. Guys, as I said, there's an alternative method also to this. That also I would teach you guys. So whichever is convenient for you, you can opt that method. So let's open the creditors ledger. So it says that opening creditors is 26,000 rupees. So opening balance is 26,000 rupees. So this 26,000 means, I have explained that this is the expenditure incurred in 18-19, but amount has not been paid. Amount has not been paid. So this is my opening balance. And closing balance given in the question is 40,000 rupees. Right. Now, advance paid to the creditors. So, opening balance. So, since advance paid to the creditors is always a debit balance, it has to come on the debit side. Opening has to come on the debit side. Opening balance. Opening balance of 5,000 rupees. Guys, if you see the entry of 5,000, what did we pass in 1819? This was the entry we would have passed. Creditor account debit to cash, which means money is gone out and creditor we kept on the debit side. In case if this guy is not giving me the stationery items, he has to give the money back to me. So, when I pass this entry, this creditor is no more credit balance, it is a debit balance item. Though creditor is a liability, no doubt, but when I pass this journal entry, creditor account debit to cash, this being the first transaction, first entry of the transaction, this means this creditor is having debit balance. Why debit balance? Because if this person is not giving me the stationery, he has to repay the 5,000 back to me. Right, so that is the reason this creditor is having a opening balance on the debit side. Similarly, the closing balance of the same creditor at the end of the financial year is 7,000 rupees. So this particular creditor during the financial year, I have paid him 7,000 rupees. This is the entry for this 7,000 rupees. Creditor account to cash, which means the 7,000 indicates money paid. But creditor has not given me the stationary items. Hence, this 7,000 rupees will also have the debit balance at the end of the year. Okay. So, I hope the opening balance and closing balance of the both accounts are clear. Guys, this is nothing but this creditor has got both debit balance as well as credit balance. So, when I say creditors, there could be two types of creditors. One creditor who works on the basis of advance. He takes advance and only then he makes the delivery of the goods. There could be another type of creditor where he delivers the goods and takes the payment later. So, this is a normal creditor. So, this creditor will have debit balance. This type of creditor will always have credit balance. But both are my creditors. So, 100% these both have to be under my liability account. Right? Now, further it says that during the current year, they have paid 89,700 rupees towards my creditors. So, 89,700 rupees is paid. Obviously, my creditor balance has to come down. So, the entry for 89,700 should be creditor to cash. Creditor to cash, 89,700 rupees. If you see my receipts and payment account, it says that payment made towards stationery is 89,700. Obviously, this payment would have gone to the creditors. Okay. Is there any other entry with regard to creditors? No. These are the only five entries. So, what is the total now on the debit side? My total would amount to 1,34,700, which is 5,000 plus 89,700 plus 40,000 rupees. So, definitely my debit side is more than credit side. So, naturally, there should be some balancing figure on the credit side. So, from 1,34,700 rupees, if you minus 26,000 and 7,000, I would get 1,01,700 rupees. So, this is nothing but during the year, this is the amount of credit purchase I have made. So this is nothing but credit purchase of 1,01,700. Guys, this is the same amount which we have derived using this method. 1,01,700. So, this is the current year's purchase. Right? Okay. Now, let me open the stock account. Stock account. So, I have stock account is my debit balance. So, opening will be on the debit side. So, opening stock is 5,000 rupees. With this, I would add my credit purchase. So, the more and more I purchase, my stock will keep increasing. If stock keeps increasing, I'll have to debit it. So, this is credit purchase, which is 1,01,700, and my closing balance is 30,000 rupees. So this is 1,06,700. The total is 1,06,700. So out of this 1,06,700, 30,000 is still not consumed. So how much is consumed will be 76,700. This is consumed. This has to go to my income and expenditure account. So, this 76,700 will go to my income and expenditure account. This is the amount that we have already taken to income and expenditure account. Guys, these are the two methods which I have taught you. Whichever seems convenient for you, you can opt that method. Right? Okay, let's go further. During the year, we have purchased billiards table worth 5,80,500 rupees. So, this billiards table is definitely is my asset, which is my capital expenditure. This is my capital expenditure. So, this will go to my balance sheet straight away. This will not go to my expenditure account. Investment of 6,19,800 is capital in nature. So, this will also go to my balance sheet straight away. Then I have miscellaneous expense of 75,000 rupees. So, to miscellaneous expense of 75,000 rupees. Straight away I can put on the outer column. Then I have furniture purchase worth 12,30,000 rupees. So this is also capital expenditure. The expenditure is in capital nature. So this will straight away go to my balance sheet, for which I would claim depreciation. But the question is silent with regard to depreciation, so I am not calculating any depreciation. Further, insurance premium paid is 27,000 rupees. So to insurance paid, to insurance paid is 27,000 rupees. I cannot record this 27,000 rupees as my entire expenditure, because they say that the second additional information says that insurance premium prepaid is 3,000 rupees, which means this 27,000 includes 3,000 rupees of payment, the benefit of which I will derive in the financial year 2021. So which means the service which I will get in 2021, for that I have made the payment in the current year. So since the benefit of this 3,000 rupees is going to come to me in 2021, expenditure also needs to be booked in 2021. So I need to remove this 3,000 from 27,000 rupees. So let's prepay insurance of 3,000. So my expenditure is 24,000 rupees. So what should have been the entry for this, guys? Insurance expense 24,000 rupees, prepaid insurance 3,000 to cash 27,000 rupees. So this will go to my income and expenditure account, this will go to my balance sheet on the asset side, and this is the cash payment that has been made. So we have got 24,000 by subtracting 3,000 from 27,000. Next is, that's all. I think we have come to the end. Now let's see whether I'm getting surplus or deficit. So the total is more on the credit side. So total is 16,20,000 rupees plus 720 plus 18,000 plus 1,80,000 rupees plus 63,000 rupees and plus 9,000 rupees. So I get 26,10,000 rupees on my credit side. 26,10,000 rupees from my credit side and debit side. So with this, I minus 4,95,000 rupees, 76,700, 75,000 minus 24,000. So I'll get surplus. So surplus income is 19,39,300. So this is my excess of income over expenditure, which will be transferred to my capital fund account in balance sheet. Guys, I hope this is making sense. So with this, we come to end of illustration 27. Thank you.